Hi, I'm Cheryl.
And I'm Nancy.
And welcome to Conversations with Nancy and Cheryl. Well, Nancy had a big event this weekend.
Yes, I did. I moved into a new house.
Yeah, and how do you feel about that?
Well, I looked forward to it for months and months and months. Mm-hmm. And this morning, I called Cheryl and I said, I woke up feeling really bummed.
That's odd. Why?
Because I thought I got up and everything was put away and everything was where it was supposed to be and it all looked real nice and everything. But all my anticipation is over. Mm-hmm. And so now I'm kind of in that void of like, what now?
Yeah.
And actually, I didn't realize that till I called my little guru this morning and said, okay, this is what's going on. Now tell me what I'm supposed to do.
Well, I think that happens. I think about it in terms of, any fun event or great weekend, generally there's that letdown afterwards, even if it was just terrific and, it wasn't let down to anything bad. You're mm-hmm. in a lovely home, you have all your things out, and you feel really good about the move. But there's that, we have filled up our time or our life with so much busyness that when we get quiet, we don't know what to do with that quiet.
And that was what it was.
Yeah, we don't know what to do. And so much of our value is based upon what it is we're doing, how busy we are, and mm-hmm. how active we are. Mm-hmm. And when we have this time, particularly this time in our life, when it isn't filled up with other people and other, other needs and experiences, that we have time to just sort of sit down and we have those quiet moments. And the first inclination is either A, let's hurry up and fill it up, or feel badly.
Yeah, mm-hmm. it doesn't feel that good to be mm-hmm. just kind of doing nothing, mm-hmm. But I actually think it's a valuable space if you can allow it.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's not easy to allow. And I think part of it is just our society, because we've just ramped mm-hmm. up everything. Mm-hmm. Everything's so fast. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that was my first thought. It's like, okay, now what do I do to fill this up? And I don't have any internet in my house. And so I was thinking, well, maybe that's what it is. No TV, no internet. I'm kind of out of touch, I don't think that's it.
No. And I think that, I think when we get into this space, I think we just have to kind of sit in that uncomfortableness. It will pass.
Yeah.
I just went through several months of that feeling as I let go, as I'm letting go of basically of one career and not quite sure where the next one and what the next things are. I've been testing it and playing around with some things, and but still just I have a lot more space in my day than I ever have before and trying to deal with that. So I think in your case, I would look at your house as you've got a lovely home, you have all your things around you. It's a great space for entertaining. So, so I think, what will that house bring to you going forward and look ahead mm-hmm. and relax into the quiet right now?
Well, the other thing is, I think that, I am always telling my patients in traditional Chinese medicine that there's the yin and yang of everything.
Mm-hmm.
This would be the yin, the quiet, silent mm-hmm. time. Mm-hmm. And without, if everything was good, it wouldn't feel good.
Mm-hmm.
We have to have the opposite so that we can appreciate the wonderful things in life.
Mm-hmm.
So while I love being around people and being active, this is the other side of the coin.
Yeah.
And so I think you have to balance it. And I don't think I'm as good at it as I would like to be.
Well, then life's giving you an opportunity
to
practice.
It is. That's exactly right.
Okay, so I guess if you find yourself in one of these spaces, or a Sunday after a great Saturday, or we're coming home from vacation, just relax in that space for a little bit and enjoy it, reflect on it, and allow it to be.
Yeah, and if you have this kind of experience, let us know on hourglassworkshops.com, mm-hmm. because there are lots of people that read, mm-hmm. Our blogs, and it would be really nice to hear somebody else's perspective.
Yeah, yeah, and maybe how do you get through that?
Right,
what works for you, because it is uncomfortable. So so it does take a while to get through it. So okay, well, good chatting with you. Until next time. You can check us out on hourglassworkshops.com, and we'll talk with you again.
Bye.
Bye now.